Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous topic we have discussed about the shape of the orbitals, and now here basically we are going to talk about the rules for filling the electrons in the orbitals. So starting the first one, that is Aufbau's principle. So what is this principle? Let me talk about that in this topic. So friends, as we know, that is an atom consists of nucleus. Obviously, it also consists of shells, subshells, and the orbitals. And the electrons are filled in it, and all the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. But the filling of the electrons, it always starts with the first shell, then second, third, and so on. So what is the reason behind this? And the electrons are filled in which orbitals first? That is the main concern. That is what we are going to talk about. That is Aufbau's principle. So let us understand what is actually Aufbau's principle and how the electrons are being filled. So for that, here basically we have a definition. That is Aufbau's principle. It states that in the ground state of an atom, the orbitals are filled with electrons in order of the increasing energies. That means the electrons will be filled in the first shell, or basically the first orbital, then the second, third, and so on. But obviously we understand that is the first shell consists of only one subshell, which consists of only one orbital. The second shell consists of two subshells, that is 2s and 2p. And here basically the 2s is the orbital, the 2px, 2py, 2pz, even that is the orbital. So here basically the electrons are being filled in various other orbitals, starting from 1s, then 2s, then 2p, and so on. So here basically let us find out that electrons are being filled in which orbital first. So electrons are being filled in the orbitals depending upon the energy. For example, suppose if we have 4s orbital. So in that case, we should understand that is the electrons are being filled according to the value of n plus l, where n represents the principal quantum number. In this case, it is 4. And L, it represents azimuthal quantum number. That is what we have discussed in the previous one. And for S orbital, the L is 0. So here basically the value of N plus L here we have got as 4. Suppose if we have another orbital, for example, 3D. So in that case, suppose if we have to make out the sum up of N plus L, that is the principal quantum number and the azimuthal quantum number. In this case, the principal quantum number is 3. But for D subshell, the azimuthal quantum number, that is L, it has been found to be, that is 2. So therefore, we will get a value of 5. So here, basically, we have two different orbitals, but the electrons will be filled in which orbital first? It will be filled in the 4s. And then after 3d, because here we can see that is the energy level, here it is 4 and then it is increasing to 5. So therefore the electrons will be filled in 4s and then after 3d. Suppose if we have another orbital, for example 4p. So in that case, what will be the value of n plus l? Here basically we have got to know that is the principal quantum number, that is 4, plus l for p orbital, that is the azimuthal quantum number, it has been found to be 1. So therefore the value is again 5. But here we have two different orbitals having the same value of n plus l. So electrons will be filled in which orbital first, 4p or 3d? It will be filled in the 3d first, if we compare it with 3d and 4p. The reason behind that is because here basically we can find the principal quantum number, that is the value of n, which is smaller number, that is 3 compared to that of 4, which means 3D orbital, it will be very much nearer to that of the nucleus, and obviously the electron will be filled here first and then after here. So basically what we have got to know, that is the electrons will be filled in the 4s orbital first, then after 3D, and then after 4p orbitals will be filled. So this is nothing but a short example where we have got to know that is how the electrons are being filled. So based on that, let me show you a particular diagram and let us analyze that is how the electrons are being filled in the orbitals. So friends, this is nothing but the Aufbau's principle diagram. So here basically we will get to know that is electrons will be filled in the first shell, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and so on. But the electrons are been filled not only in the shells, but also it depends upon the subshells as well as the orbital. So here basically we'll get to know that is the electron will be filled in the 1s orbital first, then 2s, then 2p, then 3s, then 3p, and not in 3d. It will be filled in 4s, then 3d, then 4p, then 5s, because recently we have did a particular formula based on n plus l, and we have got to know that is the 3p orbital will be filled first, and then 4s orbital will be filled, and after 4s, 3d orbital will be filled. So this is what we have discussed, and this is how basically the principle that is based on the, and this is what it is based on, the filling of electron based on the FBOS principle, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope I'll see you next time. Till then, don't forget to subscribe to EKRA channel. Thank you so much.